So let's begin. Para one. More and more companies, agencies, institutions, organizations are today in the grip of metric fixation. And that is the reason is they want to remove judgment, right? And eventually, so the first part which I write here is, what is this paragraph talking about? The start, it is about metric fixation. And the point that it look, the point people are looking at, the organizations are looking at is to make things standard and without judgment. That is this all about. Last lines now. So with numerical numerical indicators of comparative performance upon using, that is basically metrics. Best way to motivate people is by attaching rewards and penalties to performance, right? So basically, what is the objective behind all this? So this objective is the kind of performance appraisals that are based on these standardized metrics instead of using judgment. So pretty clear, right? So that is what the first paragraph is all about. Something which is easily coming out of it. All right. Let's come to para number two. The rewards can be monetary in the form of pay performance or reputational, okay, in forms of ratings, rankings, etc. But the most dramatic negative effect, okay. So the first thing which here we start with reward types, right? So rewards can be money or fame, right? And further it says, but there is a negative side to it. And what is that negative aspect? Okay, that the encouragement might lead to excessive gaming, which means that the purpose of maximization of for a metric might not be synchronous with the large purpose of the organization. So now examples are given. If the crimes become the rate of crimes become the metric according to which police officers are promoted, then some officers will not record crimes, right? Or let's take surgeons. So when success and failures are according to for the surgeons, that affects reputation and income. Surgeons will refuse to operate on patients with complicated problems because it would impact their reputation. So overall, people will suffer. So negative here is that the metrics might be the metrics might lead to gaming where people might want to incentivize. So basically, be odd with the larger objective, at odds with the larger objective. Right, so that is what is being indicated here, so that it might not always be good. So there is a negative parameter being stated. So as I read, I just keep make a note, right? That is what central idea is all about. I try to make it 8 words, right? Like this might have been 9, but it's more or less 4 to 8 words is what I try. Okay, now when reward is tied to performance, para 3 tied to performance, metrics fixation invites this sort of gaming, okay, right? But it also leads to some unintended negative consequences. So again, we are talking about more negative consequences, negatives. And what are these? Goal displacement, right? So goal displacement means what? Means that let's say you are focusing on only certain measures while you are ignoring the others. Like for example, here it is given that many goals got distorted in the No Child Left Behind Act adoption, right? Let's say suppose the focus is to test or something else. So a goal displacement means there is an expense on which means that you are focusing on some but you are ignoring others. So these setting up of goals that comes at an expense, right? Okay. So next one, next para is talking about short-termism is another negative. So again, what are we talking about here? See my focus is on what, right? We're talking on another negative of metric system. What it does is the paragraph says that it encourages immediacy of interest, right? So short-term goals. So the concern here is you want your focus is on immediate consequence at the expense of long-term consideration. So basically, this is short-term focus. It creates a long-term focus goals. So example has been given that if you are looking at a long-term research and development, if you are looking at a corporation, a long-term research and development is sacrificed, right? Because your focus is on meeting your targets, which are short-term. So that is something which often happens. Okay. Next one. So the point here is that they are also to add on. So there is another negative. And what is that? Transactional cost of metrics, which means the time that is taken in compiling and processing for the metrics and also to actually read them. So the time that gets spent, etc., in going after those metrics, that is also something which is negative. So the author definitely is not a very big fan of metric fixation. That is clear. Now let me run you through again all the central ideas here. And see if we were able to summarize the paragraph well. So the first central idea, metric fixation, it is something which leads to standardization. You can, without judgment, you can actually do performance appraisals based on these metrics. It's of majorly two types. It rewards in form of money or maybe in form of fame or reputation. But then there are negatives. Metrics might lead to gaming, where the maximization might be at odds with the larger objective of the organization. And there might also be negatives, like people might focus on some goals at the expense of others, right? Just focusing on what is being attached to the incentives. And it also leads to short-term focus and at the expense of longer-term benefits. And also there's a lot of transactional cost in understanding, reading, implementing those metrics. So the time which is spent on metrics. So that is what the article is talking about. And this is the central idea exercise. The focus is on what is every paragraph about. So I hope you get this close and you are able to learn with every passing vlog. All the best. Thank you.